name is Ofe Angela. I'm here to present a paper, the development of multimedia-based supplementary teaching materials. The table of content, introduction, multimedia as supplementary teaching materials, development of multimedia as supplementary teaching material, multimedia resources, application of multimedia in teaching and learning, advantages and disadvantages of multimedia in education, examples of multimedia in primary school, recommendation and conclusion. Introduction. Multimedia is the exciting combination of hardware and software that allows you to integrate video, animation, audio, graphic, and text resources to develop effective presentation. Development is a process in which someone or something grows and changes and becomes more advanced. While supplementary referred to as something added to complete a thing, make up for a deficiency. Teaching materials are those materials that the teacher uses to aid teaching and learning. Multimedia as supplementary teaching materials, this cannot be overemphasized because the world is a global village. It combines both hardware and software. It makes learning more exciting. It makes teaching easier. Development of multimedia and supplementary materials, this can be done through the following stakeholders: our governments, NGOs, teachers, learners, multimedia resources. Teachers' domain. In this teachers' domain, teachers will carry out all the domain in teaching and learning, that the cognitive, the psychomotor, and effective in any content development. Filmmakers online, SchoolTube, Digital Theater Plus, etc. Application of multimedia in teaching and learning. The primary application of the interaction multimedia is a situation whereby learners is giving control to review the material at his or her own pace using multimedia gadgets. Self-study and feedback using field trip learning method. Searching for information. Teacher uses multimedia gadgets to teach. Advantages of multimedia in education. Learners who learn from materials containing both text and graphic produce 55% to 121% more accurate solution to problems. Present different drawings and pictures to support clarification of ideas and communication of information. It helps moving easily from a presented subject to another and provide a good chance for questions and discussions. Using a projector or individual computers give students the opportunity to view information or materials up close. Adding sound and video makes the idea clearer and it attracts the attention of the learners. Disadvantages. In disadvantages, one, it is expensive. For we to get the material, the gadgets of multimedia is too expensive. Not everybody can afford that. Not always easy to configure or get. Sometimes it's not easy to get. Requires higher quality hardware and always compatible. Students who are not as proficiency with computer may have to spend more time learning computer skills than the content requires professionals. It makes some learners addicted and lazy to read. Learners' access to computer without restriction will expose them to internet dangers. Recommendation. The world is already a global village. I will recommend that multimedia be taken as the major way of imparting knowledge in primary, secondary, and tertiary institutions, particularly in the third world countries, so as to move with the trend. In conclusion, the principal goal of the topic of discussion is to develop a better understanding of teachers' experience with a wide variety of supplementary multimedia resources in teaching and learning, capturing in full online courses. Thank you.